Well, our journey under the skin takes us even deeper yet into what I like to refer to as key components. Now, you might disagree with me, but we're talking about the components that actually keep the, well, wheels attached to the truck. So pretty darn important stuff. We'll start with what's referred to as an upright or a hub carrier. This is the one off the Dodge. Its principal responsibility is to hold the bearing, the brakes, and of course the wheels attached to the vehicle. So it works pretty hard for a living. This is the one again off the Dodge. And frankly, looking very similar to it, a little bit different in its architecture and layout, but by weight and mass, this is the one off the GM product, give you a sense of what the Chevrolet looks like. Well, just so you get a sense of how Ford approaches this topic, I mean, if you're going to have a 4x4, you're probably going to work that thing pretty hard. Hey, Dave, if we could, would you mind dragging that thing up here? Now, if you handed this thing to me once and never mentioned the thing weighs more than what the average small home, this thing is serious. Folks, this is how Ford Motor Company approaches it on the Super Duty. Now, these are cute. I really think they are. But when you talk about it, the ability to go out there and work hard for years and years and years, this is how you build that key component. Now, so that you get a better sense of really how they approach this thing, another key component would be, well, the steering. See, this is a steering linkage off the Chevrolet. It's not bad-looking stuff, bigger than you'd see on your average car. But I want to give you a sense again on Ford's philosophy. Hey, Dave, would you mind bringing the steering keys, please? Again, this is key linkage. This is what attaches to the wheel, so you, every time you move the steering wheel, they actually go the direction you point them. It would be a good habit if they kept that up. But of course. Now, this thing, I actually see two uses for. Steering your truck, and if you remove it in the mornings, you could go ahead and do 10, 15 reps of this thing and actually get stronger yourself. Your truck is strong, and now you're strong. Do you see what I'm saying here? The approach and the philosophy is completely different. Now, another major component on all of these issues is how you attach it to the vehicle itself, i.e. the lower control arm. Now, this is off a Dodge. This is off a Dodge 4x4 heavy-duty truck. You're kidding me. I've actually seen it off small import cars or larger. This is kind of sad. Chevrolet, I'll give them credit. They kind of came to the game a little bit more serious. That's their lower control arm. This is the thing that takes all the beating. This is the suspension component that when you drop it into a pothole, go over expansion trips, nick a curb, or go off-roading, this thing works real hard. Just so you understand how Ford approaches it, if you would, Dave, I'd love to have that lower control arm. See, this is cute. You got into ping pong, this could be your puppy. But if you're into playing hardball, this is what Ford calls a lower control arm. You kind of get a sense of the difference, don't you? I mean, that's the kind of thing that permeates their thinking all the way through these trucks. Yeah, you can do it like a big car, or you can be serious about being the leader in big trucks.